Hello viewers, in this video, I will explain how to design a MATLAB code for a numerical scheme that has been proposed in this research paper titled Modeling Attractors of Chaotic Dynamical Systems with Fractal Fractional Operators. The paper was written in 2019 by authors Abdun Atanagana and me. Let me show you the scheme. So as you can see on the screen, the numerical scheme is shown by equation number 3.18 in the research paper. So this numerical scheme is used to simulate a dynamical system or a mathematical model. In other words, a system of given ordinary differential equations which are defined under fractal fractional operators with Caputo-Fabrizio differential operator. So in this scheme you can see that there are three equations. The reason is the mathematical model that I have chosen for the simulation purpose has three differential equations. So let me show you the dynamical system. So you can see the dynamical system is defined by equation number 3.4. This dynamical system has three differential equations. Equation 2 and 3 both are linear equations, while the first one is nonlinear. Because in the first differential equation, there is a term capital H, which is defined here below by a transcendental function, sine function, that has dependent variable x of t in its argument, making the first differential equation a nonlinear differential equation. And hence, the system 3.4 is a nonlinear system of differential equations. This system is defined under fractal fractional operators, and now we are going to design a MATLAB code for this system. Let me show you the MATLAB code. So this is the MATLAB code I'm going to explain. You can see on line number 9, this h is 0.01, which is the step size. T of 1 is equal to 0.1. This is the first value of the independent variable. 100 is the final mesh point of the integration interval. This T is our integration interval. Capital N is the number of iterations. Line number 10 shows initial conditions. Line number 11 is the value of the fractional order, which has been arbitrarily chosen to be 0.97. On line number 12, you can see the value of tau, which is once again chosen arbitrarily as 0.89, and this is known as fractal dimension. Line number 13, you can see values of the parameters which are required in model 3.4. M is equal to 1 is a normalization factor which is used in Caputo-Fabrizio definition. That is why it is required in our code. Now you can see line number 16, 17 and 18 is the system of differential equations which was defined in the paper by equation 3.4. Line number 21, 22 and 23 are the values for the dependent variable. The second value for each dependent variable is required based on the numerical scheme that we are going to use. Now this for loop will be used for all the three dependent variables. So for example, line number 28, you can see here that this is the numerical scheme that I had shown you in the research paper defined by equation 3.18. So this is the numerical scheme which I have actually written as a for loop for the first dependent variable. The same has been repeated with a slight difference in the notation for our second dependent variable. And finally, once again, the numerical scheme is repeated for the third dependent variable once again with a slight change in the notations. So next you can see the final last line, line number 43, in which I have plotted a face portrait, and this plot will give you the plot A of figure 15 that is in the research paper. So that's it. This is all you need to understand for a numerical scheme under the fractal fractional operators in the Caputo-Fabrizio sense. So let me run this M file, and now you can see that a chaotic behavior is obtained from this dynamical system. This face portrait is shown in the figure. So that's it. This is all you need to know in order to get a numerical scheme for a dynamical system. Now there are some other dynamical systems in the research paper which are defined with fractal fractional operators in the Caputo-Fabrizio sense. You can now simulate those dynamical systems easily. Just you need to change a couple of things. For example, you can change the fractional order, you can change the fractal dimension, you can change some parameters, and of course you need to rewrite these three equations based on the linear or non-linear, whatever the system, whatever the type of system is given, you have to write down the equations accordingly. Now finally, you can see that I have written here tick command before the for loop and toggle command after the for loop. So this, the purpose of writing these two commands will actually help you to compute the time which has been consumed by this for loop in order to present the results. So let's go to the command window, and now you can see that the total elapsed time by this M file is 0.033605 seconds. So that's it. This is all about the MATLAB code for a numerical scheme defined in that research paper. In my next video, I will explain how we can design a MATLAB code to simulate a dynamical system which is being investigated with fractal fractional operators defined in the Atangana-Baliano sense. Thank you for watching.